Now, part of us going public means ensuring a legacy for this company after I'm gone. I will start choosing a successor, and it can only be one of you.
Does successor talk have anything to do with Cookie?
What you talking about, Cookie?
I ain't spoken to her since she got out. I figured you had.
Cookie's out.
My name's Caroline Perzan, and I am the set decorator for Empire. A set decorator is someone who fills everything inside of a set or outside of a set, but the walls, but the architectural elements. So we're doing the inside of the Lucius's mansion. The set decoration team does everything such as the drapery, the carpets, the artwork, the lighting, the books, you know, you name it.
I'm living in the public eye. Here camera, there camera, I ain't never lie. We can't even be alone, they wanna take a pic. Baby, even though I'm loving life, it could be a bitch.
My favorite sets would always be the permanent sets. And the permanent sets on a TV show like Empire would be like Lucius's mansion that we're sitting in right now. Probably one of my most favorite sets because the it's all about the art on the walls. I mean, of course, it's the architecture and the beautiful mansion, but the art is inspired by our creator, Lee Daniels' love of art.
We go down this hallway and we're in the lobby of Empire Records. And there's another Barclay, his famous piece of art.
The art all started when we created Lucius's office.
Hi, Marvin Mitchell is, are you okay?
We need to go over the budget for the showcase. The bank is only, you can't keep avoiding this.
And we knew we wanted mostly contemporary African-American art. So we've mixed in like classics, like museum sort of classic paintings with hip hop type artists like Kehinde Wiley. We loved Kehinde and he turned me on to him from the very beginning.
My mouth is a weird thing. I ain't scared of nothing. They say he's so reckless.
Everyone's got a really nice vibe here and people get along. And the music is really what makes the show so special. And when you sit and you watch them rehearse and shoot with the music, the energy level turns up. With TV, we get, right now we're picked up for 18 episodes, so we'd have 18 scripts.
You are not a part of my company, and my attorneys have assured me I don't owe you a damn thing.
You're going down.
I'll get the script, I'll read it, and then I'll read it again and I'll break it down. So I'll break it down by set and location. Sometimes the writer will give me really great descriptions of the atmosphere, and I'll take those words and, you know, I'll utilize that, and then I'll talk with the director and find out if those are his feelings as well.
And there's New York City right here. Here it is. I tell my son or visitors that come here when it's not lit up, they say, that's, you know, it doesn't really look alive. And then when you turn on the lights, it all of a sudden comes alive. You know?
The research that I do and then my set decorating buyers and our art department coordinators, like everybody, you know, helps to research and then we do a presentation for the permanent sets. And once when we get down to shooting episodic, it goes so fast that we don't really have time to do the large presentations like we do for our permanent sets.
The Hollywood Secrets, it changes, you know, different parts of the nightclub and this gets lit up and they have scenes where they dance or sing here, and then sometimes this becomes a stage.
In Los Angeles, we have a world of resources. We have many, many, many prop houses. And so it's, I would say, and I could be challenged by some colleagues, but they would probably agree with me that it's probably 100 times easier to decorate a show, you know, in LA.
These are all of my binders of art.
But here, you know, when you're in Chicago, which means I'm actually contributing more to the economy here, is I'm actually utilizing a lot. I'm buying and renting a lot here in town.
How many sound stages do you occupy?
Well, now we have four.
We have four for our permanent sets.
My life, and I would say most set decorators would say this, is it's nonstop. I mean, even on the weekends when I'm not officially on the clock, I'm always thinking about what I'm going to do next. Like, what piece of art am I going to have hang on that wall? Or where am I going to find that piece of furniture?
Empire Entertainment has filed to become a publicly traded company on the New York Stock Exchange.
We're all very happy as the local crew in Chicago that Fox has made their home here. And we hope that the governor decides to support the film industry in Chicago and show off our great city and continue to support the arts.
We'll be right back because age ain't nothing but a number. The older the berry, the sweeter the juice.